Hello students, welcome back to our computer class. Students, today we are going to learn about lesson number 4, DBMS, that is Database Management System. So before that, let's learn what is data, what is information and what is database. So students, let's learn what is a data. Data can be the name of person, it can be the number, or it can be the image or sound, etc. So Chhaya, 4, Rajput Nagar, this will be your data because it is related to someone. But students, are you understanding anything from it? Is it meaningful? No. So if I write like Chhaya is a student in our school, her roll number is 4 and she lives in Rajput Nagar, then you might understand that it is an information about Chhaya, right? So students, when the data is processed and converted into a meaningful and useful form, it is known as information. So data is collected and it becomes information. But students, when this data or the information is brought together so that others or the users can retrieve it anytime, then it is database. So have you understood about what is data, what is information, and what is database? So let's see what is DBMS. Now what is DBMS? Database Management System. D stands for data, B for base, M for management and S for system. So what is Database Management System? It is nothing but the collection of programs which will enable the users to create, maintain and control the database. Students, it is a program and it will let the users to, or it will allow the users to create, to maintain and do any updation or control your database. So that is Database Management System. Before this, or in earlier period, what happened that the information was stored manually, that is in the form of files or books or ledgers, and storing the data as well as retrieving it anytime was very difficult, and it was also time consuming as they had to search it each and every time. So with computers, this problem is been erased. So Database Management System has replaced, or the computers has replaced, the papers, the files and the ledgers in and as like media for storing important information. So nowadays, whatever information is been stored is stored on a computer and not in a book. Or if there is book, then also we store the information on a computer too, so that next time when we want to retrieve the data, or when next time when we want that data back, then we can retrieve it easily. So computers helps or to manage and organize the data so that useful information can be accessed easily and also efficiently. So database is collection of related data from which users can efficiently retrieve the desired information. And also database can be simple collection of text data in a simple tabular form to a complex collection of images, audios or videos. Now data text is what school uses, right? You can take example of school. What school does? There are numerous students. Suppose there are 1000 students. So each and every time are they going to see the information about a student from the files or books? No, we have computers for it. We have stored our information about the student or about anyone from our school on the computers, and whenever we want it, we can easily retrieve that data from the computer. So DBMS also allows the same thing, but this time what happens that DBMS takes the responsibility. Like DBMS, it is the system which is already having everything with whatever we want, and it will also enable the user to create, to maintain and control the database. So whatever data we are having, if you are having DBMS also with it, then you can easily control your database, or you can easily control your data. Students, YouTube, Facebook, IRCTC, or you can say the companies, big companies, or the schools and colleges, everyone has DBMS, that is database management system, as there are lot of information to be stored, and this their information, once stored, it is not like we can't update it. We have to check it once, we have to update it twice, thrice, anytime. So for that DBMS is the best. Now why only the DBMS? Like why DBMS when we have the file system, right? So why DBMS when we have file system? So first of all, DBMS is going to reduce the development time. Then we have data independence, like we can update the data anytime, we can update however we want. How much data stronger or however the data is, you can update it. Then efficient data access, like we can access our data anytime, it is in our hand. So database management system has given us the authority for data. Then data integrity under updates. Also concurrent access. Concurrent means what? Multiple users can also access our database. Sometimes it is good, but sometimes it is not good, right? Now how it is not good? See, suppose there are three users for your database management system or DBMS. There are three users. So what happens, the user first has got the information Chhaya, 4, Rajput Nagar. Then user 2 has got the same information Chhaya, 4, Rajput Nagar, and also user 3 has got the same information, that is Chhaya, 4, Rajput Nagar. Now when updating this information into your DBMS, DBMS will stop you. It will allow multiple users to access it, but it will stop when it will see that there are redundancy happening, that is there is same thing is going to update it every time. So it will stop you over there, and it will do the updation only once, that is Chhaya, 4, Rajput Nagar will be only taken once. So this is DBMS. This is what DBMS does. Also, it is giving you recovery from the crashes. If there are any crashes, DBMS is going to help you. And also, it has a very good security, that is, it doesn't allow any unauthorized persons to access your DBMS. Let's learn about advantages of DBMS. As I said, you can update and retrieve data anytime. Like what is update and retrieve data? Suppose you are having a file, you want to update a data, that is you want to add a new record in your file. DBMS is going to allow you. If you want to cancel an update, or if you want to cancel a record or cancel a data, then DBMS is going to allow you there also. And if you want to change some information or data, then also DBMS is going to allow you. So first advantage of DBMS is update and retrieve data. Then next is concurrency. As I said, the word concurrency means multiple users. So multiple times or multiple users can allow, or they are able to access your DBMS or your database. So whatever data is there, multiple users can access it, and then the computer or the system is not going to get hacked. Also, there is recovery of data, that is DBMS can take the authority, or it can support you for backups every time. As I said, they are also having security. So DBMS gives a very strong security for your data, as there is also data integrity. Now whatever data you are storing, is it a correct information or is it inconsistent data is not stored and all, that will be seen by DBMS. It will also control data redundancy. Now what is redundancy? Same data is not being updated or deleted every time, that is been seen by DBMS. So redundancy is same data, you can say replicating data, it will remove that directly. Then data sharing, you can share your data also. If you want to share your data with someone else, then you can do that. And ease of application development, however you want it, you can take your DBMS or you can have your DBMS. So ease of application development. Now where are this DBMS or database system used? Let's see that. So first of all, they are used in travel industry. Now airlines or airports and all, railways like IRCTC and all, hotels, cab industries, everyone, they are using database system only. They are using online database for reservations, for room bookings, or you can say for displaying the schedule information about a person or about anyone you want or anything you want. Like railways, you can say that you are going to search in IRCTC, let's say you are going to search about the railway, when is the train going to arrive, everything is been shown to you. And only whatever you want, that is only shown to you. Not everything is been there on the screen and you have to search from it. You can search any train which you want and you can see the information which you want. So that is database system. Then also it is used in banking and finance, that is students in banks also, the DBMS is hugely used. And in finance, that is stocks and bonds of data, like all these useful things, like for online trading, customer accounts, loans and other transactions, DBMS is used in banking and finance. In education, as I said, schools and colleges also use databases for the course registration, you can say about results and information of the students or staff or anything. Then there comes e-commerce. Now e-commerce, you have learned it in 7th standard. What is e-commerce? So see, you might have seen that business activity such as online shoppings like Myntra, Flipkart, or booking of holiday packages like you have Make My Trip, you have Goibibo, then consulting a doctor, that also is done on e-commerce. So they all use e-commerce, they all use database system. They have a very huge database systems for there. Then healthcare industry, as you can see in hospitals, this database is used at a huge amount for keeping the information of the patients, their records and their history, healthcare details of the patients. This DBMS is used. Digital library and publishing, also DBMS is used. Now whichever book or which book has been taken by someone, or is that book available right now or not available, that has been seen, or that has been stored by DBMS only. Also DBMS manages a very huge amount of text and multimedia data. And students, human resources, like in organizations or industries, what happens, this DBMS is used for storing the information about their employees, or about the salaries of the employees, or about benefits, what profit they have got or what losses they have got, and also about the taxes and for generating salary checks and all. So these are the areas where DBMS is used. So basically DBMS or database system is used everywhere. Okay, then what are the components of DBMS? See, first of all, there is a user. Now what is an user? User is a person who can access the data or data by using a DBMS, and that is also, that user is also called as database user. Then there is an administrator, that is database administrator. And who is this person? It is the person who directly or who directs and performs all the activities related to maintaining a successful database environment. So all the responsibilities like designing, implementing, maintaining the database system and providing security, training to employees, this is done by database administrator. And at last comes application program. So what does an application program do? So it is any program designed to perform specific function. You can say directly for the user or for another application program or operating system also. Like MS Access is there, like that. So students, I hope that you have understood about our components of DBMS. You have understood about where the DBMS is used, and very great thing, that what is a DBMS. Okay.